Okay, so you're building a system and you want to make that system nice and robust. So this is where a concept called object value types in domain-driven design is really handy, right? So what is a object value type? Firstly, there is a concept called primitive obsession, right? Where your whole application relies on primitive data where, you could actually have that as its own object value type. Let's take this CodePost application I built, for example, right? So as you can see here, there's some bad data in the system. This is in production. This was a project I threw together, right? So every post is required to have a title. Yet here, as you can see, there is no title on this post. And that partly is just pure poor validation on my part, right? Hacking a project together. And quite easily, you could have used a struct validation library or something like that to do that, which works fine, again, but you're then leaving your application relying on primitives. And also, struct validation libraries aren't also ideal in some scenarios, right? So let's talk about this in a domain-driven design aspect, right? So this is an application that I'm currently building with a friend, and we have here a barbershop domain type. And as you can see, we've got an ID, a name, a slug, and at the time it's registered at, right? So we want to make sure, obviously, that this is a really robust system, and we want to make sure that no bad names can be entered and signed up with special characters, all that sort of stuff, right? And we also want to make sure, repositories can return correct data, etc., right? So what we've got here is we've got a new method for this domain, which takes in these object value types that implement a string type, so we can turn it back to primitives when we need to. So you don't have to just have like a object value type for like an email, say, where it's just a string. One I'll go over, which I used one for recently, was a legal name, right? So this was actually a struct, because I wanted this legal name in parts, right? So I wanted like a first name, a middle name, and a last name, which were obviously all strings. So then you would have a legal name object value type. So instead of just passing through name, like a name string throughout your application, which hasn't got these parts to it, where sometimes there's cases you'll need them, you have a specific type that you can pass around your application, which moves your logic away from relying on that primitive again. And then you can have methods on here like new legal name, which goes and it might take in an actual name string and then actually validates you have a first name and a middle name or a last name, or you might have some special logic that only checks you have a last name and a middle name, etc. And then obviously you can then implement something like a if I do legal name, you can implement the stringer interface or just string to go and return this as a string. So then you could actually join, all three of these fields together and get it back to your string. Usually or typically you will have to go through this name new name factory, right? Obviously you don't have to because these are both publicly accessible, because there are times where you probably do want to convert a type to name if you need to manually, right? But ideally, and you can obviously make sure your code enforces this with unit tests, etc., any type of data coming into your system would go through this new factory method. So this is where your kind of validation on your business data applies, right? So we know that a name cannot be empty, so we have, a case to catch that. We know that a name can't be too long, so we have a case to catch that. We also only want Latin characters in our strings, right? So we have a regex compiler, well, a must compile up here, to match on invalid characters and correct sequences, etc. And then finally, once we've got through all of these checks, we can then actually return our object value type. So if we go to a service method, for example, so i.e. register, you know that once it's got past these factory checks, any data that actually gets to our business logic slash repositories or data layers, etc., all have the correct validation and speak the language of your service, right? And like I say, I've been bitten with this before. So you don't really have to use object value types everywhere, obviously, but where it makes sense, like something like an email address, which is a very important piece of data for, accounts in a system, having your own email type that just goes and performs a bunch of validation, like bad characters in it, actually like trying to pass it with the standard library, etc., further checks where you can actually catch these real small edge cases, the better, right? And that then enables you to unit test your core functionality on these types. So obviously what you could do is you could go and test these individual factory functions just to make sure they're working correctly. But obviously, you also want to ensure your services actually use these methods in it to get data correctly into your system. So if we take the register unit test we've got here, we literally just spin in a bunch of unit tests that take in our primitive types on the request. So this is technically like a DTO or a primitive data transfer layer object that we pass into our service methods that then turn those primitive types into our object value types. Object value types can make your system really robust, and that's something that I think some systems lack. So yeah, something to think about. There's some more videos on domain-driven design that I'm planning to make soon, so keep an eye out and I'll catch you all later.